Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to learn about digestion and absorption of lipids. At the end of this video, you should be able to describe digestion and absorption of dietary lipids, explain the role of bile salts in digestion and absorption of lipids, and describe the abnormalities of digestion and absorption of dietary lipids. What is digestion? It is a process which involves the hydrolysis of large and complex molecules present in the foodstuffs into smaller and preferably water-soluble molecules, which can be easily absorbed by the gastrointestinal tract for utilization by the organism. Process of digestion and absorption is complicated and it occurs in the gastrointestinal tract and involves many organs, like liver, which is involved in the synthesis of bile acids and bile salts. Gallbladder plays a role in storage of bile. Pancreas plays a very important role by releasing bicarbonate solution and various enzymes required for digestion. And small intestine is important in final digestion of lipids and absorption of digested products. The process of digestion and absorption involves six important steps. First, minor digestion of triacylglycerol in mouth and stomach by lingual and gastric lipase. Second, major digestion of all lipids in the lumen of duodenum or jejunum by pancreatic lipolytic enzymes. Third, bile acid facilitates formation of mixed micelles, which has role in absorption. Fourth is passive absorption of products of lipolysis from the mixed micelle into the intestinal epithelial cell. Fifth is the re-esterification of 2-monoacylglycerol with free fatty acid inside the intestinal cell. And sixth is the assembly of chylomicrons containing apoprotein B48, ApoA1, triacylglycerol, cholesterol esters and phospholipid, and export of this chylomicron from intestinal cell into the lymphatics. These are the six important steps of digestion and absorption of lipids. Dietary lipids contain triacylglycerol, cholesterol, phospholipids, and 80-90% of dietary lipids are triacylglycerol. The enzyme lingual lipase, it is acid stable in nature and it is synthesized by the glands which are present at back of the tongue. And this enzyme enters stomach along with the food. And digestion of lipid in mouth is insignificant. Digestion of lipids begins in stomach. It is carried out by two important enzymes, lingual lipase and gastric lipase. Gastric lipase is secreted by chief cells of gastric mucosa on stimulation by gastrin. Lingual and gastric lipase hydrolyze triacylglycerol containing short and medium chain fatty acids which are present in the milk. And this digestion in stomach is important in case of neonates and in patients with pancreatic insufficiency, for example, cystic fibrosis. The second step is digestion of lipids in small intestine. The process of emulsification is essential for the digestion of lipids in small intestine, and this emulsification process is brought about by two complementary mechanisms. First is the detergent action of bile salts and second is the mechanical mixing by peristalsis. What is this emulsification? It is the process of dispersion of lipids into smaller droplets due to reduction in surface tension and increase in the surface area of lipid droplets. So larger lipid droplet is converted or broken down into smaller lipid droplets so that there is increase in surface area so that the lipases can act on the surface area of smaller lipid droplets. These bile salts, they are synthesized in the liver and they are stored in the bile and secreted in the duodenum, and they interact with these lipid molecules and convert them into smaller fat droplets. So the detergent action of bile salt is important for this emulsification process. In addition to this, the bile salt also prevent these fat droplets to again form a larger molecule. So they keep them in the smaller form. Mechanical peristalsis also helps in the emulsification process, and that's how the process of emulsification is very important in digestion of lipids in small intestine. Digestion of lipids is carried out by hydrolytic enzymes, and the secretion of hydrolytic enzymes is controlled by hormones, namely cholecystokinin, CCK, and secretin. Cholecystokinin is released by cells in the mucosa of lower duodenum and jejunum, and this is stimulated by presence of lipids. Cholecystokinin acts on gallbladder and causes its contraction and release of bile. Bile contains bile salts, phospholipids, and free cholesterol. Bile salts play a very important role in emulsification and micelle formation. Cholecystokinin also acts on exocrine cells of pancreas, and there is release of digestive enzyme by these exocrine cells, which plays important role in digestion of lipids. Cholecystokinin prevent the gastric motility, means it decreases the gastric motility, which results in slower release of gastric contents into small intestine. The second hormone, secretin, it is also synthesized by intestinal cells in response to low pH of chyme entering the stomach. It acts on the pancreas and liver to produce bicarbonate-rich solution. And this bicarbonate-rich solution helps to neutralize the pH of intestinal content, bringing them to the appropriate pH, which is suitable for digestive activity of pancreatic enzymes. Pancreatic enzymes are mainly responsible for digestion of lipids in intestine. Pancreatic lipase causes hydrolysis of triacylglycerol. Cholesterol esterase causes hydrolysis of cholesterol esters. Phospholipase A2 causes hydrolysis of phospholipids. There is one more enzyme which is secreted by pancreas, and it is colipase. It is secreted from pancreas as procolipase, and then it is converted into colipase by the action of trypsin. Without this colipase, pancreatic lipase cannot act on triacylglycerol, because the bile salts which are present in the intestine prevent the action of pancreatic lipase on triacylglycerol, and this problem is overcome by colipase. This colipase binds at the lipid aqueous interface, and it helps to anchor and stabilize the pancreatic lipase so that it can act on triacylglycerol. Now let's see how it acts on triacylglycerol and causes its hydrolysis. This is the structure of triacylglycerol. Pancreatic lipase acts on the fatty acids at C1 and C3 position, and it leads to formation of 2 monoacylglycerol and release of 2 fatty acids. Cholesterol esterase hydrolyzes cholesterol esters to form cholesterol and fatty acid. Phosphatidylcholine or lecithin is the predominant phospholipid present during digestion, and it is hydrolyzed by the action of enzyme phospholipase A2. This phospholipase A2 specifically cleaves fatty acid present at the C2 position in this phosphatidylcholine, and it results into release of lysolecithin and 1 fatty acid. Now the fatty acid which is present at C1 position, it is released by the action of enzyme lysophospholipase to form glycerophosphorylcholine and fatty acids. This glycerophosphorylcholine can be further excreted in feces or degraded or get reabsorbed. The primary products of lipid digestion are free fatty acids, free cholesterol, 2 monoacylglycerol, and lysophospholipids. Bile salts are essential for absorption of lipids. They form mixed micelles with the lipids, and these mixed micelles consist of free fatty acids, free cholesterol, 2 monoacylglycerol, bile salts, fat soluble vitamins like A, D, E, and K, lysophospholipids. It is a disc like structure wherein at the periphery bile salts are present, and mostly all lipid molecules are present in the center. and this mixed micelle serve as the major vehicle for transport of lipids from the intestinal lumen to the membrane of intestinal mucosal cells, which is the site of lipid absorption. All the lipid components are absorbed in the intestinal mucosal cells by passive diffusion. All the lipid components are absorbed in the intestinal mucosal cells, but the rate of absorption is different. 2 monoacylglycerol and 3 fatty acids, they are absorbed completely, while only 40% of cholesterol is absorbed. This depends on the solubility in water. And short and medium chain fatty acids are not dependent on micelle formation for the absorption. The fifth step is reesterification, which occurs in intestinal mucosal cells. But short and medium chain fatty acids having less than 10 carbons are directly absorbed in intestinal mucosal cells. They do not undergo any reesterification or any modification, and they are directly transported in portal circulation and then transported to liver bound to albumin. Long chain fatty acids are absorbed in the intestinal mucosal cells. They are activated by the action of enzyme thiokinase to form fatty acyl-CoA. These fatty acyl derivatives are used for esterification of 2 monoacylglycerol, lysophospholipid, cholesterol. 2 monoacylglycerol, by the action of enzyme acyl transferase and in presence of acyl derivatives, diacylglycerol is formed, and likewise triacylglycerol is formed. Lysophospholipids are absorbed in the intestinal mucosal cells, and with the help of acyl transferase and acyl derivative, there is esterification of lysophospholipid to form phospholipids. Cholesterol esterification occurs with the help of fatty acyl derivative and acyl transferase, and cholesterol esters are formed. Vitamin A, D, E, K are also absorbed in the intestinal mucosal cells. Two apoproteins, ApoB48 and ApoA1, they are synthesized in the intestinal mucosal cell. And now all the lipid components are assembled in the chylomicron. Chylomicron is the lipoprotein which carries dietary lipids or exogenous lipids from intestine to the liver. And the phospholipid forms outer layer, outer membrane of this chylomicron. Apoprotein B48 and A1 gets incorporated in this, and all other lipid components like triacylglycerol, cholesterol esters, vitamin ADA, they form the core of this chylomicron. This chylomicron is later secreted through the lymphatic system, and then through the thoracic duct it enters general circulation, and then it reaches to liver. This chylomicron metabolism has been described in detail in the video on chylomicron metabolism. Now let's talk about abnormalities of lipid digestion and absorption. Steatorrhea is the condition of loss of lipids in feces if it is more than 6 grams per day. The causes of steatorrhea are, first, if the digestion is defective. If there is defect in the secretion of pancreatic juice or bile, then in this condition there is defective digestion and the fat which is excreted in feces is unspilt fat. In case of defective absorption by intestinal cell, the fat which is present in feces is spilt fat. And steatorrhea occurs in the disorders associated with pancreas, biliary obstruction and severe liver dysfunction. Abnormalities of digestion. Cystic fibrosis is an autosomal recessive disease. It is caused due to mutation in the gene for cystic fibrosis transmembrane regulator protein, that is CFTR protein. This is involved in the chloride transport, and the mutation occurs due to deletion of 508th phenylalanine residue. This protein functions as a chloride channel on the epithelium, and if the CFTR is defective, it results in decreased secretion of chloride and increased reabsorption of sodium and water. And the secretions become thick and viscous, and because of that, The pancreatic enzymes are not able to reach the intestine and it results into pancreatic insufficiency and they also lead to various infections. In this condition, excessive chloride secretion occurs through sweat and sweat chloride tests become positive. Alveolar sacs also blocked by the mucus because the secretions become thick and they are prone to infection. And that's why in the cystic fibrosis, there is pancreatic insufficiency and severe pulmonary infections occur. Abnormalities of digestion and absorption can occur due to obstruction due to cholesterol stones or gallstones. Because of this stone, the passage of bile into the duodenum is blocked, and as bile is not able to enter in the duodenum, the emulsification cannot occur, so there will be defective digestion. And as no bile salts are there, no micelle formation is there, so absorption will also be defective. So in case of the gallstones which block the passage of bile in duodenum, it leads to abnormal digestion and absorption. Why milk and coconut oil is recommended in fat malabsorption syndromes? Because milk and coconut oil are made up of medium chain fatty acids. Triacylglycerol with small chain and medium chain fatty acids do not require micellization for their absorption in the intestinal mucosal cells. They are not re-esterified in the mucosal cell and they are absorbed directly into the bloodstream. They enter portal circulation and they are transported to liver bound to albumin and they can be utilized by the peripheral cells.